What I was informed of by the whistleblower is that a group of Health and Human Services employees were sent to Travis and March Air Force Base to work alongside CDC officials to help the individuals coming back from Wuhan, China. They were working within the quarantine area of the base. They came in contact with the patients, and they were not given proper protocol on how to interact with them. Sometimes they had gloves and they had no mask. Sometimes they had mask and no glove. The CDC individuals on the ground, officials on the ground, had full protective gear and even respirators at times. So that was alarming to them enough to think, if I'm here and I don't have the gear that they have and they have it in that same quarantine, then I should be trying to take steps to protect myself. And that's how it came about. A discrepancy of protocols between CDC and the folks at Health and Human Services. It's to my knowledge, the CDC did follow all the appropriate protocols on the ground. Health and Human Services did not. If this complaint is correct, then these individuals were exposed to a contagion that might be spreading. And that's why we're pushing to get this investigated, to get them tested, to make sure that they're not getting sick. I don't necessarily have confidence in Secretary Azar's when it comes to taking steps to remediate this breach in protocol. One of the things that we're trying to do is get information from his office and from him. So myself and Chairman Neal of the Ways and Means Committee submitted a list of questions asking about this breach of protocol that occurred at Travis Air Force Base, or at least allegedly occurred. So we're waiting for those responses, and we're going to keep pushing until we get them.